To discuss about bronchiectasis. It is a type of chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases which is also expressed as COPD, in which mucus accumulates and sticks in the airways of the lungs. This leads to repeated serious lung infection. It can also cause by lung injuries, tuberculosis, pneumonia, etc. Now we will see the types. First will be cylindrical bronchiectasis. It is the mildest form and reflects the loss of normal tapering of the airways. Second type will be sacular bronchiectasis, is more severe with further distortion of the airway wall. Now we will move on the third. This cystic bronchiectasis, it is the most severe form of bronchiectasis, and fortunately it is the least common form. Now we will see etiology and risk factor of this. First one, severe pneumonia. Next, tuberculosis and similar infections will be present. Alcohol and drug abuse can cause this. Bronchial obstructions will be present. Whooping cough, rheumatoid arthritis, ulcerative colitis. Now we will see the pathophysiology. So, first one, inhalation of dust, bacteria and other small particles. Then it will get obstruction of the airways. Next, it will lead to the inflammation of the wall of the airways. Next, it will spread of infection into the air space of the lungs. Now we will move on to clinical manifestation. False smell or bad breath will be common. Next, wheezing, coughing up to the lots of sputum. Cyanosis, discoloration of the body color due to the lack of oxygen. Next, shortness of the breath, weakness and weight loss will be there. Recurring chest infection will be there. Next is hemoptysis. It means blood in the vomiting. Now we will see diagnostic evaluation. In that, it will include history collection, physical examination, CT scan, X-ray and pulmonary function test, which is also called as PFTS. Now we will move on to management. So, bronchodilators, medications such as tetrofim, steroids such as salmeterol, oral inhaler, antibiotics may use to control respiratory infection. Respiratory therapies can help to clear airways. Next is daily exercise such as walking and swimming can help to clear lungs mucus. Next is hydration. Hydration will help airways mucus from becoming thick and sticky. Next, oxygen therapy should be started. After medication, if no cure, then surgery should be done such as lobectomy. In this, damaged lobes will be removed. Now we will see nursing management and administer medication as per doctor's order. Advise patient to take plenty of fluid. Administer oxygen therapy as per doctor's order. Encourage patient to do gentle daily exercises. Thank you.